Hi, I'm Esmeralda Quintana. I'm a ZOS performance analyst here at the PQFC site. I just want to show you one of the machines I work on. So come. So this is a Z14, double wide. All right. So I could probably live in this thing. At a glance, we'll get into it, but this is power we have behind this, IO. More power with the SAC up there, IO, and our processors. So we're gonna move the SC out the way. So up here, this is our power supply. We have two batteries up here. Something to know about the batteries is, you know, they're kind of small. They do a very specific job. If power goes out, we want to make sure that we complete transactions in flight, right? Because data integrity is incredibly important to us and you, hopefully, right? So over here, you see this nest of IO. These are all PCIe IO cards. You can see that we have a ton. We have even more on the back. There's some over there too. And if you just look at the rat's nest that goes down and is fed into the bottom, these cards, we have OSA, FICON, we even have ZDC for data compression. A lot of cards here doing a lot of jobs, moving a lot of data. Okay. Now this side, as I promised, even more IO cards. Like I said, more on the back. We have another battery pack over here. And up here is the SE. Now, if you look, we talk about all this IO, right? Come here. We have a switch for the internal network. We have that much activity going on that we need this. It's incredibly complex. And while you're looking, take a peep at this thing, okay? So this is a light bar, right? So let's just say you're working on the frame, right? And you notice, you know, IO card is going down, or maybe you just want to upgrade one. Maybe you have a problem child CP, but you're working remote. What you gonna do? You can actually talk to the SC and light this up. This will actually point an on-site technician in the right direction. This will route them to a specific location. Now, real quick, oh, come here, it's right here. There's a light board for PCIe cards as well, right? So that allows you to just, you know, very easily communicate where your technician needs to go. Now, I mentioned the SC. The SC does a lot more than blinking lights. So, you know, an airplane, right? You ever see the cockpit? Full of knobs, right? Like just bells and whistles everywhere. That's what the SE is at a glance. So you think about this huge frame, you can tell it's complex, right? You saw those wires, you see this amount of processor drawers. What the SE does, it's the buttons and knobs of the airplane, right? So let's just think about an LPAR. What do you need to set up for an LPAR? Number of processors, are they shared or dedicated? How much storage? And then certainly you would have the real estate for that amount of buttons necessary. I mean, this thing is huge, I could live in it. But you don't want to handle that, right? You don't want to deal with all those buttons. The SC allows you that level of control in both a GUI tool called the HMC, so the command line interface. So right here, we have two of them, right? Just like two pilots on an airplane. Redundancy is incredibly important. The two SC servers are up here. So you know, if you had one and you lost it, you're gonna land that plane blindly. So redundancy is important. That's the SC, very good. All right, so here's our processors. Now we have four drawers, right? One, two, three, four. Each drawer itself has tubes of coolant, pushing in cold water, taking out hot. That coolant's mean pipes. Down here, it's hitting the radiator, it's cooling, warm air is blowing in the back, which I think I'll show you. So let's do some quick math, right? Each one of these drawers has five chips. Don't be confused. Each chip has 7 to 10 cores. So let's take the lowball of processors available, right? 5 times 7 times 4. That's 140 processors. 140. That's a lot. So I want to show you the back so you can see how this thing's being cooled. Okay. So this is an absolute wind tunnel. This is a nice summer breeze. This is behind the processors. They're all getting cooled and this air is coming out hot. So she is working very hard. And as I promised, more IO over here, battery pack. I'm going to try to close this. All right, real quick. So you know I wasn't lying. Even more IO cards on the back. She's nice and warm, actually. And those are the back of our power supply. And look at the nest, too. Remember, the other side, we have just as many over here. So where are those wires going? We have network, right? But we also have storage. This is the back of one of our storage units. You can see just as many wires, right? Not as interesting from the back. You can see the complexity of the network that's hooked into this. This machine is not just hooked online, but it's hooked to many of the frames we have on site. right? And this is the front of our hybrid storage. Now, it looks pretty, right? Look here. Every one of these storage arrays is full. Full of what? Each one of these slots has about 2 terabytes of storage. I'm not even gonna try to do quick math and add that up. So we have so many of these. What are these guys over here? If you look closely, you can see these are all, this is flash, solid state. So we have tons of storage going out of this. These guys are incredibly fast, working on fast networks with those fast PCIe cards. And since this is hooked up to so many things on site, remember the SC? We had a computer for our computer. We did it again. Right here, this guy controls the storage, like the data. So every machine that hooks up to this doesn't want to worry about what everybody else is doing. This guy handles your data integrity for you at a very, very, very good performance, which is really incredibly important when you're dealing with finite storage. So yeah, so backing up, I don't know if you want to take a glance at like the machines we have here. We've got a lot, okay? Just like that Z14, we've got like 20 in the back. And that's just one floor of one building here at the Poughkeepsie Labs. So a lot of work being done at any moment, a lot of machines turned on, a lot of warm air being blown up back. So thank you. I hope this inspires you to learn a lot more about the mainframe. So you can see they're incredibly complex, and I had fun with it. Okay, thank you.